by a one who's found everything to live for. I asked him if he was proud of me as he laid his pecan-colored face on my chest, and he replied yes. And I went through my mind a thousand times to figure out what that could possibly mean. Every single option ended in motivation for me. So you may not be afraid to die, but I found something to live for. That's a dangerous motive. Afraid to let them down. That's why I don't put this pen down. As we sat down and traced out African kings and queens of past, absent of sound, his face absent of stress, I watched as that pencil pressed and impressed and regressed all at the same time. It reminded me of my own approach. Live and let learn, teach and be taught, take it all in. And I may not remember it all, but this just gonna have to do for now. He's taught me more than I can ever give them credit for, and there's one thing for sure. I see their face when I step on stages. When I put these 2 feet down on pavement. When I put those words down on pages. I got 2 little boys sitting at home waiting on me. You think I'm gonna let the world take that from me? This is my gift to society, my rites of passage. Music, I remain calm, but inside I'm losing it. You're not too cool for me. And I reciprocate that sentiment. I'll never be too cool for you. You be standing tall because you saw me do it. That's an effect that has been noted. But please let it be noted that I told my job they can dock my pay, but right now it's just way more important to take you to school every day. Just so you can walk through those doors with your chest poked out and you've allowed me to. I won't stand tall because of you. And a lot of what I'm teaching you, your grandparents taught me. And these streets can't have rubber, come way too selfish. I'm taking myself out of so many situations, I've become so selfless. Voice for being a father is an honor, a duty, a choice, and I chose you. Nobody else. If you fail, it's all on me. Nobody else. Not even your wonderful mother, as amazing as she is. And that she is, but if you fail, it's all on me. And I remember the first time I talked to him on the phone, I was down in Texas performing, and I told him I'm just trying my best to make you proud. He probably had no clue of what I was saying to him because he was only 2. But he ended that conversation with, I love you. And I cried. I live. You may not be afraid to die, but I found something to live for, and that's a dangerous motive forever fueled. Your thoughts may be involuntary, but these actions are very calculated. I was a man with a plan, but now I'm a dad with a decree, and you can't take that from me. My sons ain't raised by no coward, and they won't be one either. So if this be the mesh of a man, then y'all still gonna need way more meters. I take it too far so they never come up short, and that's an extended metaphor. What's more dangerous? Someone is not afraid to die. Or one who's found everything.